Hey guys, welcome to this week's video. How you guys doing? First, I want to thank you guys for supporting us from the beginning. And some of you like to see the, you know, the island that's going around the island. Obviously, we're not on the island right now. We do get a lot of questions and emails, and we try to balance the video so we can make everybody happy. You know, it's not always easy to do that, but we try our best. And the last two videos, more educational driven, about expats buying property, about the mortgage. We'll be doing more of those. And I just want to thank you because the support's been great and very positive once again. And I think that's awesome. So this video is going to be, I guess, more of a family time video. My mom's coming up with my brothers. I'm going to hang out. You know, I think every time we kind of hook up with family and friends, stress level is always lower. It helps the overall stress, kind of gives you a break. And then, you know, and obviously we do a lot of that on Pico, as a lot of you know, but we're trying to do more of that here. So today, that's, I'm going to be in charge of the barbecue, charcoal, and Laura's doing some food inside, and I think it's just gonna be nice just to hang out, talk about Pico, talk about Canada, talk about what's happening, and just have a good time. So hopefully you guys will join us for that. Obviously not a lot of education on this one, but we hope you enjoy it. One reason that I thought of doing this video is also because a lot of people back home, we have a lot of family there, a lot of friends, not only in Portugal, but in Canada, in the States. And I don't think a lot of people have seen my mom recently. And I thought, I'll have to ask if she can be on the camera, if she's okay with being in the camera. But I think it'd be nice for my relatives and my, you know, friends, a lot of people that know her from when she lived in Pico with my dad and the whole family, that they can see her. They can see that she's doing pretty awesome. And yeah, that's another reason why I thought, you know what, let's just do this video, this family time. But first, yeah, so we hope you enjoy the video. Now, I'm gonna first, before anything, I'm just looking around here, and Laura loves gardening, as you know, and she's done a great job. I'm just been a bit of an assistant, but she's pretty much done everything. And let's take a look at what she put together here. Okay, so here we're in the garden here, the backyard, and she decided to do, let's see, look, we planted peppers, and they're coming along very nicely. A little bit of peppers there, and lots of tomato, cherry tomatoes. Look at this, there's loads of them. There's about three or four different types of tomatoes, varieties, and I just can't wait. If you can just smell this, eh? I love the smell of tomato. A lot of lettuce, got some beans coming in here. Okay, look at this. So that's gonna be awesome. And she even decided to grow corn. When she told me about it, I said, I kind of laughed, but look at this. I think we're gonna pick this one soon, you know? So some of these beans didn't really take, these ones here, but you know, there's no perfection. Here's some more tomatoes. And everybody knows what those are. Couves, colored greens. Some insects really also love eating them. And there's, I can see that they've been at it. There's a zucchini, we got a few already. Yeah, so, you know, it's very, again, we try to do things that kind of give us a break from sitting at the computer, you know, and gardening is one of the top, for sure. And I'm learning a lot from Laura, because she's right into it. Oh, look at this. Didn't realize this sunflower just came in. Wow. And we're in an area here, hanging out at in Streetsville, not far from Oakville, 20 minutes away, about 25 minutes from Toronto. Yeah, I'm gonna hang out here, and let me just see. We got this really cheap barbecue charcoal. There it is, and that's where I'm gonna do all the chicken from. Can't forget about our herbs. So one of these herbs, we don't find a lot of these. It's basil. And obviously for anyone that cooks Italian, you gotta have basil. And there's parsley and some rosemary, el crin, because you need basil. Basil is one of those things, without basil, your Italian recipes would not be the same. So we're just getting this barbecue organized. Okay, I don't do a lot of charcoal cooking. I'm actually a bit more used to doing wood cooking back on Pico, but let's, you know, I'm getting a little bit more used to it. Nice charcoal there. And yeah, let's hope that we can create a good fire here for our chicken. It's funny when I back on Pico and basically try to help out making, creating a fire there with the wood, because a lot of the, like my cousins and my friends that live on Pico, they do a lot of that. And it's funny, my cousin Louis always says to me, "Ne sache pas nada." It's like a saying that we have, and but I'm learning, Louis.
Carlos did a nice job lighting the barbecue.
Of course he did.
He's still learning.
Now this is charcoal, it's a lot different. I just hope I don't light myself on fire. Here's Laura, hard at work. What do you got here?
Hi guys. Just getting some vegetables together.
Oh, that looks good. Fresh. Got some shrimp too.
Yeah, nice. We got shrimp and some.
What else we got on the menu?
Well, Carlos, I guess you're barbecuing chicken today.
Yeah.
And what else do we have? Oh, potato salad. Carlos made potato salad and a bean salad. And your mom's bringing something.
It's a secret dish.
It's a secret dish. We don't know, yeah. But we'll show you guys later.
Yes, and I'm sure there'll be a bit of dessert. And I think there'll be some wine, too. But this looks really good. And yeah, look at the table. Oh, that's nice. Nice and set. Should be fun. Now I got to get back out to the barbecue. The chicken is in and cooking very well. And I just wanted to let a secret out. We mentioned before that my mom's cooking a secret dish. I know what it is. Laura doesn't. It's her favorite dish. It's a codfish dish. It's famous back in Portugal, so that's what she's bringing over. And one reason why we love, you know, like barbecue, especially around Pico with the wood and all that, and it's because of the simplicity of it. Like this barbecue behind me, it's $99. Does the trick, but it's the simplicity. It takes a little bit of extra work, just like when you're barbecuing with wood back home. You got to shoot a skater, you got to put in the wood, you got to get the wood, you got to... You know, and it's a slow process, so kind of you get focused on it, and it's all about the nature, really, when you're cooking like that. And that's one of the things that we enjoy quite a bit is when we're cooking on with wood. It's coming along. Feel the heat. Real strong. What I do is I finish these in the oven the last 10 minutes with the piti piti sauce, and it's just unbelievable taste. Salute. Uma fresquinha.
He's going to be putting on his secret sauce on the chicken.
See the smoke here? That's how you know it's actually still hot. It's still coming along. Maybe another 10, 15 minutes. And this is my secret ingredient. I can't really tell you what it is. I'll have to kill you, as they say in the movies. Look at this. Look, can you smell this?
That's looking really good.
Smell that? Huh? Piti piti, piti piti. Looks like it's pretty much done. We're at the finishing touches now, but it is hot. Sun just came out, it's pretty humid. Look how nice this is. Okay, I'm just gonna put the chicken down. And then we're gonna let it cook inside here for a little longer. Oh, no, this is the key to all this. This thing here, the scent of this. Just keep it
I'm
moist.
Getting very smoked out.
Garlic, olive oil, lemon, parsley.
Yeah.
Rosemary, eh?
Looking good.
Look at this. And I thought during this barbecue break, I would talk a little bit about Pico. And because I was just talking to my cousin Louis a little bit earlier, and he was telling me how busy it is over there. A lot of tourists. As you know, the summer there, the high season is between June 15 to about September 15. So right now it's at the max, and you can't get accommodations, no cars, hard to get restaurants, and it was the same situation last year. One reason why we started promoting in the off season, so any other time, we're really trying to promote that, because I think the more we educate people out there, they're going to get to realize that even though there's mixed weather, so which means you get to feel more of the nature, it's great there in the off season, okay? And I think more people are finding that out. I think also the good ground handlers of Pico, they keep getting better, and they are handling the situation. And it's good to see that, okay? Because you need to be able to handle the tourists when they come in properly, and I think they're doing that. And I think it's just going to continue to get better. We're actually working with our partner as well and putting a couple of tours together, small, with the Triangle Islands there, and obviously the workshop, but also some tourists that want to come and hang out and kind of discover Saint George, Fayal, and Pico. So it's good to see that we're doing those in the off season, not in the summer, and I think we'll be better off for it, because we love being there in September and October, November. We had a great time this winter there as well. So I think it's just it's amazing. I love to hear that. I know that it gets overwhelming sometimes, but you know what? Good job, guys, there on Pico. All you, running those accommodations, those vacation rentals, the hotels, the car rentals, the activity companies. I mean, kudos to you. And we'll see you guys there soon. And on that note, why don't we just pause and take one of those much needed Pico breaks. Pico, I also want to add a good friend of ours, Charlie Monroe, also a follower and an expat now that has purchased a property on Pico. We've mentioned him and Maggie quite a few times. An amazing artist. He is showing his unbelievable work at the Atlantico Tea House and Wine House, just on the edge of Madalena.
Hi, I'm Charlie Monroe. Today we're on the island of Pico, about to go visit my art exhibit at the Atlantico Tea House in Madalena. Pico Island is in the middle of the Azores. The island behind me is Fayal. I've decided to paint some of the local area people. I hope you enjoy the exhibit. I'm just going to take a walk through, so come along.
Thank you.
enjoyed the exhibit, and we'll see you next time. Ciao.
I would encourage you to go there. He's there for a month, so if you are in Pico, just come by. And it's amazing. His art, this series is on Pico lifestyle. Definitely worthwhile. We wish we were there to go and check it out ourselves live, but we've seen some of his paintings. It's incredible. So we just wanted to give him a shout out. And and also the chicken wings here at the tea house are amazing as well. So maybe you can come by and say hello to Charlie and check out his work. All right. Okay, so the gang's arrived. That's everybody knows Nelson. There, it's my brother, and that's Cesar, my other brother. That's Liz. That's Cesar's wife now. You guys probably saw the wedding on one of the videos.
Liz is from Saint-Jean.
And they're still married. Ready to go? Okay.
Yeah.
There, you know Laura, and that's Sonia, Nelson's wife, and my mom.
And Sonia is from Porto.
Porto, yeah.
Exactly. The town. What's the name of the town?
And you like Porto? Is that your favorite team?
Yes.
Okay, good. You were sweating there for a while. All right, so we're all just waiting for having some refreshments. You guys hungry?
Yes.
And my mom, she's a special guest. She'll be joining us in a bit. So let's see where my mom is. It's too hot for her to be outside or even for us, but we're out there. And there she is. Hello.
Hello.
Então, tá calor. Tá fresquinho aqui dentro.
It's very inside.
Ah, tá bom?
Tá mais fresquinho aqui.
Tá bom, okay.
Hey guys, we're ready to eat. The table is full. We've got potato salad and carrots and chicken. And what is this Portuguese dish?
Bacalhau.
Bacalhau. My favorite.
How about my chicken? How's the chicken?
Yes, and the chicken. And we've got the bean salad. We are going to have a feast tonight. All right, let's eat, guys. Well, guys, we had an amazing dinner, and now we all feel like sleeping.
Do you like your treat?
The treat?
Yeah.
What's the treat?
The bacalhau.
Oh, the bacalhau. I have to say, your mom's bacalhau is the best. Sorry for anyone else that makes bacalhau. She makes the best.
I think it's the best. For those that don't know, bacalhau
means cod. Yeah, bacalhau is cod. She makes cod and potatoes and onions and boiled eggs and olive oil. It's delicious.
Nice.
It's to my
wedding.
Yeah.
A lot of comments during the wedding.
Yes, the food was delicious. The bacalhau was amazing. She's the best cook there is.
Yeah.
But I have to say, kudos to Carlos. The chicken was fantastic as well. And so was the beans. Everything was good, which is why we're all feeling very
like
stuffed
comatose.
Right now. But yes, comatose. But enjoying it very much. We miss you all. Can't wait to go back to the Azores where we can get a lot of the same food in abundance.
Now and you have some family in São Jorge, right?
Yes, that's where my parents are from, São Jorge, so I got lots of family there. Hello to everybody there in Faial, in Seda, and now Pico, my new family.
You're scattered.
So I can't wait to go. Cheers to everybody.
And that's Portuguese.
There's Cesar.
Hello, everybody. Mm-hmm. I'm a little exhausted from chewing on all the food inside. And, honestly, I was asleep until about 2 minutes ago when Liz woke me up. But you know what? You can't ask for better than this. You know, it's a beautiful day here in our part of the country, which is far from where Pico is, but you know, it's always close to our hearts and everywhere else. But
yeah. Any fans that you want to say hello to?
I want to say to all my fans. I don't like to leave any of my fans out. There's always room for new fans, just ready, you know, just dial me up and I'm ready for any kind of fan you need. I can blow on your face. I can be a real fan, any fan. But yeah, no, now we're just enjoying. Look, I'm on water, so
when you come in to Pico next.
I hope to God that I would say tomorrow, but it's probably not going to happen. It'd be a big lie.
Even though we're by the airport.
I'm going to say 2023, and I'm going to point at this woman right here to get me there.
Right. No pressure.
Lots of pressure. That's too much pressure already.
You guys, what do you got to say?
Oh, everything was delicious.
Yes.
It's too bad I don't have a bigger stomach to eat more.
Yeah, I don't.
That's the only downfall in that.
You guys want to say hello to anybody back home?
Well,
I know Matzinge.
Yeah, hello Matzinge. I miss you so much.
Nelson?
Well, if I go start saying how many people there that I miss, well, I wouldn't be here all night long. Until tomorrow morning.
How was the food?
It was amazing. Amazing. Like Laura already said, the cod
and the chicken
made by Chef Emma.
Yeah, can't beat that. Speaking of Emma, I gotta go try and find her.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, go find your mom.
All right, let's see what she is. Okay, Mike, foi a comida hoje?
A comida foi maravilhosa. Comemos bacalhau, comemos galinha de barbecue e vamos agora comer pudim de flan. Temos
bolo doce,
cakes, bolos doce. Não falta nada.
E o pessoal.
E temos estar todos aqui em conjunto, todos muito amigos, todos contentes. Isto para mim é uma alegria quando vejo toda a gente assim. As minhas noras, os meus filhos, olha.
E agora quer dizer alguma coisa às pessoas do Pico?
Eu agora quero mandar saudades a todos. Tenho saudades de todos mesmo. Na família, amigos, vizinhos, toda a gente está no meu coração.
São Mateus?
Em São Mateus, em... E na ilha toda que tenho amigos.
E as lajes?
E nas lajes então não se fala nisso. Saudades de dar um passeio nas lajes, de olhar para um castelete. Quero mandar saudades à minha família toda. Grandes beijos e abraços, são sem fim. E para o irmão, cunhadas. Irmão agora já é só um, infelizmente. É assim. Para os meus sobrinhos, sobrinhas. Toda a gente, se me esqueçam alguém, desculpem, mas eu penso que é toda a gente. E a Maria Amélia também, que eu não vejo para ela.
Pois, agora é só uma visita, agora é só visitar.
Agora então, é de visitar, quando calhar bem, se calhar bem.
Tá bom, ok.
So it was nice that my mom got to connect with some of her family and friends. Every time we're there, they're always asking about her, how she is, and they also ask about my brothers, Nelson and Cesar. So we thought that this was a good opportunity to get them on film, and so they can see for themselves how they're doing and so forth. They can say hello to them, and it worked out very well. They actually surprised myself and my sister, Lasani, with birthday cakes. Our birthdays were the same day about a week ago.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Sonia Girls. Happy birthday to you guys.
And it was very nice. It was nice that my mom got to connect with her family and friends back home. They got to see her. Obviously, her messages were mostly in Portuguese. So for those of you that don't speak the language, that's what she was doing. Anyways, we hope you enjoyed hanging out with us for a bit. Thumbs up if you have a chance. Subscribe if you haven't done so. And see you on the next video.